When does a hero's journey begin? The moment you step outside the safety of your homes? Or when you realize the fight has just begun? Is it when you comprehend how small you are compared to the vastness?
Greetings, everyone. Jay the Filthy Casual here, coming to you live through the internet. So, how about today's trailer? Oh my god. That is one hell of a trailer, eh? Hits you right in the feels. One of the best animations I've seen them do in a long time. So what am I going to do? I'm going to celebrate. Go back to the original plane where all of this happened. So, without further ado, one of the most expensive. I mean, there could be other ones. Let's say budget expensive box openings. So, as you guys know, Dominaria is coming up in price. And unlike Rudy's, this knife is sharp. So this box is coming up in price. Estimated value now that the printing is done to be around $200 per box. That's not to say that everything in it will be $200. However, we will take a look. Some things that would be of note. Teferi, Karn, and Lyra. All my Dominaria has been good to me. One box I pulled 3 Teferis, and another box I pulled 2 Karns. So, hopefully this will work out better. Or just as good. So, this box was provided to me by Everything Games, Langford's premier gaming store. You can see them at www.everythinggames.ca. So, let's get started. Oh, Mending of Dominaria and a foil chalet right out of the box. That's nice. And that's it. So, token, land, commons, uncommons. There is some uncommons in this set that are worth some money, so we'll just set those aside. A foil chalet is nice. Flying, you and planeswalkers you control and other creatures you have control have hexproof. That's going to be good in the new set, too. Alright. Let's see here. Common. Chainers, Sarah, Joras, and Nabon. Come on now. This one doesn't want me in it. Jeez. Alright, common. Wizard's Lightning, Zephyrian Void, Mox Amber. Look at that. That's going to shoot up in price too. Danitha. Some pretty good pulls so far, wow. I don't know why, but these packs are harder to open than Battle Bond was. Alright. Amethyrine Wall, Gaea's Blessing, Josu Vess. It's not too bad. His kicker's nice. I actually got to use him in my pre-release. So I've been kind of lucky. I've been able to reinvest some funds into the channel here, which is why I've been able to do a couple of box openings. However, if you feel free or if you like this kind of thing, stop by the Patreon. The Antiquities War. Nice. Ooh, throwing packs around. Wow. Let's open the one that dropped. Maybe it's Maybe it's a good one. All right. So, Skizik, Shield of the Realm, Forebearer's Blade, and Wrath. All right. Now, most people say, why open packs instead of buying the cards you need? I like it. I like opening packs. Brings me back to when I was a kid. Now, even back then, they were like, oh, just buy what you need. That's unusual. Uncommon, 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 Grand Warlord. They were out of order. Weird. Getting close to being halfway through. Alright. Oh, it's a white card. White legendary. Alright. Oh, another Chalet. I say Chalet. Some people say, actually, how would you pronounce that? Put it in the comments. I'd like to know. I say Chalet. You got the SH and then the LA. Alright. Oh. Board the Weatherlight. Mistress Self Replicator. One of only like three cards I haven't pulled until now. And board the Weatherlight. Another good uncommon. That is, if it hasn't already, going to spike. With the Planeswalkers. Because it targets legendaries. Which is what they are. So it's good to see. It's a black card. Memorial. Goblin. Oh, nope. Territory Allosaur. Blessing of Bell's Knock. And Yargle. Yargle. So I still have somewhat of a cold, which sucks. Stuffy nose. Alright. Elfheim, Creators, Isolated Chapel. Nice. I'm all about the lands. I like these new land arts on the remakes. Unfortunately, I don't think there's been a remake on the Buddy Lands. And I definitely know the Painlands haven't been reprinted in a long time. Oop. Lingering Phantom, Memorial of Glory, Howling Golem, and Jorah. Getting a lot of mythics. It's kind of reminiscent of one of my other boxes. Still looking for one of the Planeswalkers, though. Got the foil rare, though, so I don't think we're going to see any foil Planeswalkers. Retort, Onslaught, Hinterland Harbor, nice. Getting lots of lands. I like the lands. As a commander player, they come in handy. Although I'm thinking of switching from having decks with all the cards in it to proxies. So basically you have a binder that has all your cards in it, and then as you pull a deck out, you just swap out the cards from your binder into the deck with proxies. Proxies go into your binder. And then, basically what you do is, whenever you play a deck, you just swap out the cards. So Fire Fist, another board the Weatherlight, and Goblin Chain Whirler. Nice. I could use those all day long. Getting into the halfway point. Oh. Nature Spiral, Sage of Lot Nam, Orcish Vandal, Foiled Talarian Scholar, and Naru. Loyal Talarian Scholar. If I ever meet the prof, I'll have him sign that. Now, generally, I don't give away my foils unless they're worth money. Then I'll trade them away or sell them. Just because you never know when you might need a foil. Lingering Phantom, Juggernaut, Fall of Thran. Alright. Coming up, I think this is the halfway point right here. It would be nice to have a foil Teferi or a foil Karn. Pull something that's like worth a ton of money. That'd be nice. I'm pretty sure my my annual leave would be good. Joda. I am looking for a date stamped Joda if anyone has one. I'd be willing to pay for that. I think he's 10 bucks right now. Alright. Alright, Urza's Tome, Knight of Malice, Lich's Mastery, that's going to go up too. There's a couple of new cards that are coming out that would work perfect with the Lich's Mastery. Alright. Alright. Oh, it's a blue card, I think. Time of Ice, Sanctum Spirit, nope, Steel of Champion, I needed one of them. Slingvoda. Needed one of them for my elf deck. Three casting, 5/4, can't be jump blocked. Yeah, I'll take it. Benefits from Tribal, can't complain about that. Alright, Elfheim Druid, Merfolk Trickster, Karn, there it is. Karn, Scion of Urza. So I'm now 3-3. Maybe we can go for the playset. Just need to pull one of each. I like that Karn. Much better than the other Karn. Alright. Goblin Warchief, Seal Away, Tempest Jin, and a Sorcerer's Wand. A foiled Sorcerer's Wand. So that was kind of nice. The Karn was in the middle of the box. Kind of actually, I think all three of my boxes, there was a Planeswalker there. Hmm. Cast Down, there's a good one. Sorcerer's Wand, Daring Archaeologist, and my man Slamfoot. Alright. In Bolas Clutches. Yep, not anymore. Settle the Score and Haphazard Bombardment and a Foil Planes. Alright. Last one of the middle row. Memorial Genus, Flame of Keld, On Sarah's Wings, and Squee! Yoink. Alright, last, 10 packs? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 packs. In Bolas' Clutches, Shield of the Realm, First Eruption, and a Foil Crozian Druid. It's not bad. If it's kicked, gain 10 life. Alright, got a little battery light. Let's try and get this done. So, where'd it go? Multani? 1, 2, 3. Alright. Hold in there, little camera. You're almost done. Woodland Cemetery? 1, 2, 3. Alright. I do have spare batteries, but the problem is that it would have taken a while to change it. Sulphur Falls. I'm getting all the lands. Nice. Almost there. Time of Ice and Darngaz. 1, 2, 3. 6 packs left. Almost there. Hang in there, camera. We're almost there. Mirari Conjecture. 1, 2, 3. Oh, wow. Alright. Sparring Construct, Helm of the Host. That's a good one. 1, 2, and whoops. Throwing cards everywhere. 1, 2, 3. Marwyn. I needed a Marwyn. Nice. 4 packs left. Alright. As we wind down, I'd like to thank everyone for joining Thran Temporal Gateway. I don't think it's been worth the precognition field. I don't think it's been worth the $160, but got some good pulls, stuff I need anyways. The lands are nice for my commander decks. Zahid. 1, 2, 3. Last pack. Yoink. Vanellish Marshall. And Dampening Sphere. Alright, so that was my Dominaria box opening. It was pretty decent, to say the least. I got Teferi, Mox Amber, Foiled Chalet. So with that, I'd like to thank you all for stopping by, and again, if you'd like to see more box openings like this in the future, feel free to stop by the Patreon for as low as $1 a day. You get a signed card sent in the mail every month, and then you get a promotional foil.
Hi, I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual, former Knight of the Roundtable and CEO of TPS Gaming. If you liked today's video, feel free to drop a comment, click like, and subscribe. To be notified of the next upload or live stream, don't forget the bell. It's 2019, and we have a lot in store for you, like affiliations with the following. Inked Gaming, a leader in customizable gaming supplies, from mouse pads and dice bags, table mats, and binders. Use promo code THEFILTHYCAS at checkout to receive 10% off your order. As an added bonus, receive free shipping on all orders over $75. Portion of sales benefits the channel. And Everything Games, Langford's premium gaming and hobby shop, carrying everything from Magic Gathering, Warhammer, Attack, Linky Forge, and much more. Online sales can be found at www.everythinggames.ca. I would like to thank the current patrons, but without you, I would not be able to keep the lights on. And remember, shop at your local game store. They are the foundations of the gaming community. Without them, none of us would have a place to play. Thanks for watching. I'm Jay, the Filthy Casual.